The call room is entering lockdown. Please step away.
All right, I've got to get to the elevators. That shouldn't be too hard, I think. The fastest way is probably this way.
The core is under lockdown. Please proceed to the nearest elevator to vacate the premises. Lockdown is in effect. All non-essential personnel must vacate the core immediately.
Oh, shit.
All right.
Please proceed to the nearest elevator.
Are they right around the corner?
All non-essential
yes, they are.
Personnel must proceed to the nearest elevator and report to their assigned security station immediately.
Are they gonna do anything?
The plan was to head back up that way, but I think the plan's changed.
Are they just gonna stare at each other? Hello? Hello? Okay. I guess I'll go the other way and see what happens. Maybe I missed a trigger or something.
This console's locked tight.
Or maybe I need to use the security bot? At the security station to take them out or something? I don't know. But, I mean, if they're guarding that door, then why wouldn't they all be looking out? Why would they be just standing right outside the front of it staring at each other? That doesn't make any sense.
Damien said that I can control a spider remotely because it's a docking pad for the spiders.
Okay, apparently I don't do that. Nope.
It's securely locked.
This is such a dramatic escape!
The console's locked.
Dun 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 dun! Okay, now I'm coming at this from the other side. Is something gonna happen? What the fuck? Alright, something's bugged, right? Either there's something I'm really not getting, or something is bugged. Hey guys, you awake? Okay, something's definitely bugged.
Commandos. Commandos. Not again.
Interesting. Right. Bye.
Elevator. That's probably...
Well, that was the easiest escape ever. Didn't even have to worry about them. Okay, those I have to worry about.
Find April. Save April.
I did. I found her. But what is it you want me to do? She doesn't need to be saved.
Save me.
Is she April? Is she also called April? Or is she some sort of a version of April? Oh. Well, this is quite the rainforest.
There are so many different trees in here. It's like a zoo for plants. There's so much life in here. Those flowers are beautiful.
This is really beautiful, and extremely green. Why is it so green?
Those flowers are beautiful.
What the fuck? The hell is that thing?
Stop. Stop. Don't come any closer. How'd you get here? Who are you? You're not supposed to be up here. This floor's restricted. Leave. Now!
The thing is disgusting. What is it?
What is this place?
I said, leave, right? Wait. I recognize you. You're that girl, the one from Casablanca. The one who was with that awful reporter.
Yeah, I mean, he already knows who I am. There's no point in denying it.
I'm Zoë. What do you know about Reza?
Yes, you're the one. The pretty one with the big brown eyes. I recognize your scent and your voice.
My scent?
You don't know how blind you really are until you can recognize a person by his or her scent. I smelled you in that reporter's apartment. Outside, too, when you left. You followed him here. Why did you do that? Is it love?
How could you... Oh, the cat. I knew there was something about that cat.
My pets are everywhere. You can't escape them. I may be blind and deaf, but I see and hear everything.
What did you do to Reza?
Reza? The reporter? The one who calls himself Jericho, the bumper shit. If you seek to destroy what I've spent my life creating, you'd better come prepared. Your friend, he was not prepared. When he hooked himself up to the dreamer, I saw him. All of him. And I fed on him. You were in there, in his head, in his dreams. All of you. Naked, writhing, alive, sweating, mooning. I enjoyed that. It made me hard.
Where is he? What have you done to him, you monster?
He's in a very dark place. His dreams are gone. I took them. But why can't I take yours? What makes you so special?
I don't know, that's a good question. Also, that thing is fucking disgusting. Oh.
Tell me where I can find Reza.
You're too late. He's dead.
That's not... No. You're lying. You're lying. He's still alive, I know it. You piece of shit. Tell me where Reza is, now.
No! If you come closer, I'll have you destroyed. I'll have you torn to pieces, bit by bit. I don't want to destroy you. I want to learn from you.
What?
You're different from the others. And you're connected to that fucking girl, the one who's destroying my web. You will stay, and I will study you.
Is that so? What's going to stop me from ripping those cables from your body right now? Will you survive that? You monster.
Don't you dare. Oh, finally. My most treasured pets are here. I'll take good care of you, I promise. You'll stay here with me, Zoë. And together we will explore that mind of yours.
I don't think so.
Your thoughts and dreams will open up to me like a book. And I will read them all. I will find out who you are. I'll find out what you're doing to me.
You're not getting me. And I'll be back for you. I promise.
Do you know who I am? Do you? I created this place. I created this company. I am this company. I see everything. I know everything. I know that you're working with that horrible diseased child. Her infection spreads across my web like weed in a garden. My beautiful garden. She makes me blind again. Deaf. Lost. Trapped. In the dark. I won't let that happen again. I'm not going back into the darkness. Never. 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 Take her. Now. Now.
Can I escape out here? Oh, I guess this way. Oh, shit. Wait, did she just get me with one hit? Holy shit, that was a powerful karate chop. Okay, let's try that again.
Let her escape.
Oh, killed with one hit. Really? Hope that holds. It's pretty thin. Come on, come on, come on. What the hell is that thing? Some sort of cleaner bot? Well, I'm guessing I'm gonna ride it down.
It might be able to carry me down to the street. But it'd be a real leap of faith.
Let's go, let's go. Come on, come on, come on. Please tell me it's strong enough.
Hello? Who's this?
Damien? It's Zoë.
Zoë, thank God. I'm so relieved to hear your voice. Are you okay? Where are you?
That's not important. Alley, that's...
I'm alley. Outside the walls. In an alley. I can't see any signs.
Just a moment. I'll pull you up on my, actually, I'm not receiving any signal here. You're a ghost.
What? Oh, my friend Liv. She installed some kind of shield for my mobile. She said it makes me invisible.
It's amazingly effective. Top grade stuff. I really need to meet this friend of yours.
I think she'd like you. Look, I want to get as far away from this place as possible.
You can crash at my place tonight. There's not a lot of space, but you'll be safe there.
Thanks. That sounds perfect. I could definitely use a shower and a change of clothes.
I'll try and guide you to a place where we can meet. The first thing you need to do is find the boardwalk.
It does sound as though the Azadi have plans with this tower, Aprilan, but I cannot see what that would be. They claim to shun magic, even though this technology of theirs relies on it. Maybe the tower is such a device, a magical machine.
Maybe it's a weapon,
I got the sense that it was very important that they make their deadline.
From what little I know of the Azadi, they have never previously built such a thing, but it is possible. They have powerful thermaturgists, these Westlanders, and I suspect that their hostility to magic comes from their wish to control it, and their fear that others may know more about magic than they do. As for this place you discovered deep below us, this chamber of dreams.
I'm not sure that's the right word, but I don't know how else to describe it. I could hear the voices of thousands of people around me. I'm sure it's connected to the tower. The chamber appears to be located right below it, and the man I followed from the tower led me there.
This worries me, April On. Dreams are powerful things. Combined with this Azadi machine, if that is what it is, it could have serious consequences. I shall send word to my blood sister in Irhad. She has connections in the strangest of places. Maybe she knows more. I would also have liked to see this chamber with my own eyes. Perhaps then I would understand more.
I tried going back through, but the rock's solid. There's half a mile of mountain between us and the caves. Without the portal, there's no way down there.
I will look at the wall in the cellar where you said the portal opened up. Perhaps I can learn how this musical magic works. I must say that I am intrigued. It reminds me a great deal of Bunda magic. They sing to the earth to dig their tunnels. The Bunda songs do not work on rock, but the magic could still be related.
Keep this under wraps, Na'ane. Don't let anyone get wind of what you're doing, not even Benrime. We don't know what we're dealing with yet.
Of course. I shall be cautious. Perhaps this is the opportunity we have been praying for, if we do not soon find a weakness in the Azadi front.
And we keep fighting them with the weapons we already have. What else can we do?
I am not suggesting we lay down our arms, April On, but we are fast dwindling in numbers. Not a day goes by when someone is not killed, captured, and sent west to an unknown fate, or abandons the cause. We may soon need an alternative to force. They are many, we are few, and the Azadi support among the common people grows daily.
We're not dead yet, Na'ane, and it might be that this new information will help us. If that tower is as important as I suspect it is, we have a new target. I'll talk to some contacts, see what they know and what they've heard. Tell Bren and Chuan to get the remaining supplies on their own. They'll need to leave tomorrow evening as planned. We can't afford any delays.
Will you not go with them?
I haven't decided yet. It depends on what information I manage to dig up. If I get a lead, I'll have to follow it.
So be it. I may wait for you, but I will leave a message with Benrime if I, too, set course for home. May the stars guide you, April On. We will see each other again soon.
So it seems like the Azadi's opposition to magic is just basically a front to attempt to control it. So that they will then be the top magicians.
Benrime?
Sword Child, did you find that person you were looking for last evening?
What? Oh, no, I... No.
What's the matter? You seem distracted.
I'm okay, Benrime.
All right. Well, the day is getting on. If there's anything you need, come see me.
Actually, Benrime, there is something. I'm confused.
About what, child?
I'm not sure what to do, and I would appreciate your advice.
I see. Well, child, I'll do the best I can, though I'm no wise woman. What's wrong?
I think something's going on, something potentially bad. Something involving the balance between the twin worlds.
Ah. Does this have anything to do with that nice young woman from Stark? Zoë, was it?
It may. It does, but I can't tell you all the details. I don't even understand what's going on. I'm just worried that I might be involved somehow.
I see, and you would prefer not to be involved.
I've done my share for the balance, and I have more pressing concerns. People depend on me.
Yes, they do. But that is no excuse.
I'm not looking for excuses. I'm looking for answers. I need to know what I'm supposed to do this time.
Such answers aren't always easy to come by, April. Often, we have to rely on faith alone to carry us through. Still, I understand that you want something more concrete than that, April. Very well. Here's my advice. You must speak with the Guardian of the Balance.
I've thought the same thing, but it's impossible. I can't shift anymore, and even if I could, the Guardian's realm is closed to me.
Maybe so, and maybe not. There is someone out there who might be able to help you.
Who?
An old friend of yours. The White of the Drake Kin. The White Dragon.
You're right. If anyone can help me contact the Guardian, it's her. But I don't know where she is. She vanished just after she was born.
You are April Ryan. I'm certain that someone in this city can help you locate her. Have faith in yourself and in the Balance.
I had faith once, Benrime. Look where it got me. What's left of the person I used to be?
I still see the same girl who walked through that door a decade past.
I'm not her anymore. I don't even remember what she was like. Now I'm just...
Well, I'll be damned. April Bloody Ryan. I can't believe it.
Who? Brian? Brian Westhouse?
The very same. God damn, I can't believe it's you. How the hell are you?
Is it good to see him again? I didn't exactly like him when I originally met him. He was just a drunkard. Yeah, why are you here?
What are you doing here? I thought you were dead.
Likewise. You don't seem particularly pleased to see me again.
I'm surprised is all. Where have you been?
Oh, here and there. I've done a fair bit of traveling. Well, more than a fair bit, to be honest. I rarely stayed in one place for more than a month. I guess the Tyran invasion got me thinking about the world outside of Mercuria and life outside of the bottle. You could call it an awakening of sorts.
Fine, I'll trust him.
Sorry to give you the third degree, Brian, but I have my reasons for being cautious.
I understand. I don't believe in coincidences myself. And I'm sure there's a good reason we've bumped into each other like this.
So what are you doing at the Journeyman?
Just revisiting old haunts. And hoping to score a cup of Benrime's mulled wine, of course. How about yourself?
Same thing. I'm in the city for only a few days.
Well, even more fortuitous that we bumped into each other then.
So you've been traveling for the past decade?
I have, and I intend to keep traveling for the next decade or two, as long as I have my health. This world is fascinating.
You look so much better since the last time I met you. Younger, healthier, happier.
I do feel fantastic. I was bitter and angry back then. Angry at myself, at being stuck in this world. Now I don't see Arcadia as a prison anymore. I see it as an opportunity to grow and learn and experience. I'd forgotten why I crossed the divide in the first place. I wanted to go where few had gone, where there were still untrodden paths. Losing my home, being forced to run, it was certainly an awakening, and one I sorely needed.
Speaking of coincidences, maybe you can help me with something.
Absolutely. What do you need?
There's something going on, something that may be affecting both worlds.
Why, Ms. Ryan, you seem to get drawn into these things every time. Can you be any more specific?
It's more a feeling than anything else, so I need to confirm my suspicions. Or, preferably, disprove them. I need to speak with the Guardian.
Who better to tell you if anything's happening with the Balance? So, why not just shift there?
I can't. I've lost the power to shift. But it was never that easy to get to the Guardian's realm in the first place. So to find the Guardian, I need a little help from someone else. The White Dragon.
Oh, yes. I'd imagine she could give you some pointers.
The problem is, I don't know where to find her. She could be anywhere.
Not so. I may know where to find her. I met a fellow traveler, a Dolmari from the Rose Court, actually, on a ship from Gien to Irhad not long ago. He told me he'd been to the Dark People's Library. Not many people are allowed there, and it was a great privilege. While he was there, however, he said that he was introduced to a pale, white-haired woman who introduced herself as the White of the Drykin. Now, I don't know if she's still there or how you'll get to the Dark People's City, but it should at least get you on the right path.
It does. Thank you, Brian. This is very helpful. It was good seeing you again. Are you staying long?
Another week, perhaps. Enough time to visit friends and pick up some things that I can't get elsewhere in this world. Then it's off to sea again. I've been thinking about heading east, perhaps convincing a whale rider to take me along on a hunt.
Sounds exciting. Take care, Brian.
And you, Ms. Ryan. April. Now, I have business with the innkeeper. So, how about it, Benrime? Do you have a cup or four of your mulled wine to spare for an old drunkard?
As I remember at Westhouse, you still owe me money on your tab from before the war.
My God, you have the memory of a stick man. Miss Selman, I've honestly missed this place. Hell, you're probably right. I owed a lot of people money back then. Seeing as I'm still a bit short on cash, you'll have to add this to my tab. But I'm coming into some gold tomorrow. Old debts repaid, so I'll settle it then.
That'll be the day the Azadi decide to just up and leave. Money first, mulled wine after.
You're a tough woman, and I respect that. I have to tell you about this tavern I visited in a town near Altaban.
You know, is it just me, or does it seem like Sarah Hamilton's voice acting for April Ryan has gotten worse since the first game? Because in the first game, she was incredible. Truly the best, some of the best voice acting I've ever heard for anything. And now she's just good. Just good, not amazing, just good. Is that just me? Anyone else feel that way? Anyway, alright, I've got to pay a visit to the Dark People. How do I do that? What the hell is that? Is that a child? Or some sort of a weird alien? No, it's a child. And let me guess, this one doesn't sound like a child either.
I don't understand how anyone could talk badly about the Azadi. I think the Azadi are brilliant.
Yep, that's not a kid. Okay, just based on my last playthrough of the game, I think I know where to go now. I think I need to go to that building that was up sort of on a hill past Crazy Clara. I think that's where I need to go. And I think I get to meet a certain feathered friend there. Hello.
Why, hello there, ma'am. What an absolutely wonderful day to be exploring the city.
Wonderful.
Reserve your spices for delivery tomorrow or next week.
Someone lives here. no doubt driven out of their home by the Azadi.
All right, let's see if I'm right. What is this? Is this a way for me to talk inside?
Solid stuff. They're magical.
Hello, yes?
Here we go. Delivery?
Delivery.
Delivery of what?
Sheets.
We do not issue sheets to our prisoners. It must be a mistake. Good day.
Wait, this is a prison?
Yes.
I'm going to inspect it.
Prison inspection.
Prison inspection.
Yeah, prison inspection.
This is Friar's Keep. One doesn't inspect Friar's Keep. You must have us confused with the city jail over on Cold Stone. Good day.
Sorry, wrong door.
Okay, so I'm pretty sure I do come here, but I guess not right now. I'm not sure what else I do. I need to do something else first. Let's see, what can I do? Well, I need to get to the Dark People, so I presume I need to ask someone how I would go about doing that. Wait, do I have anything written here? Nope, of course not. Maybe I need to go back to the tavern and talk to my people? Ask them how I would go about getting to the Dark People? Hey, I just saw you. What the hell? There's clones of you.
I just don't understand all this fuss about freedom and democracy. What's so different about Mercuria now that the Azadi run things? It smells the same to me.
Yeah, because smell is the only thing that matters. Not freedom. Hello? Anyone? Shit, there's no one here.
We have to travel light, and we have to stay packed. Just, if there's one thing we have enough of, it's weaponry. What we need more of is food, warm clothes, and medicine.
Okay.
Which turned out to be fermented pig's blood. He couldn't stand up straight for 3 days.
Southlanders. So you have visited Altaban and Mount Terba.
I've been further south still, to the Capes and beyond. I tell you, if you think the winter here is harsh, you should count your lucky stars. There are lands beyond the South Sea that are frozen through both winter and summer. The sun is as cold as the moon down there.
Well, I do not intend to leave Mercuria. There's enough foreigners here. No need to travel for months to find more of them. You've seen their empire?
I have indeed. They will let anyone enter and stay in their lands just as long as you respect their customs and... as long as you're human, of course.
What is it like? Do they treat their own people as harshly as they do ours?
I wouldn't know what the Azadi are like here in Mercuria, but in Sadir they were reserved but friendly, and as a man, I had less freedom than a woman. Still, I encountered no animosity. People took me in, fed me, told me about their history and religion. I learned a lot. Whatever the Azadi have done here, they are not cruel or evil. They do put a lot of faith in their goddess and their empresses, yes, but it's heartfelt.
Heartfelt, I'm sure. And they can have their empire. But what gave them the right to come here and impose themselves on us? I'm sure you will find the White of the Kin. You are April Ryan, after all.
Thanks for letting us stay here. I know you're taking a big risk by doing that.
I accepted that risk a long time ago, April. I could not simply stand idly by and let the Azadi terrorize my friends and customers. This is my small way of helping the rebels. I'm more useful here than I would be with a sword. I just hope that my contribution will have some effect, and that one day our city and peoples will be free again.
You should come east with us, Benrime. You'll be safe there, and your skills are needed.
They are needed here, too. And I do not want to abandon my inn or my customers. Also, fewer and fewer are willing to deal with non-humans. If I leave, who leaves next? Soon the city will not only belong to the enemy, it will be populated by the Azadi alone. What then of Old Town and its inhabitants? If no one's left to speak up, I fear the Azadi will simply burn it to the ground, together with everyone inside. So no, April. I need to stay here. This is where I'm needed the most.
Why is there a fire poker thing sticking through her hair? She has it in her right hand, doesn't she? It's going through her entire body. That's gotta be painful.
Heard any news lately, Benrime?
I hear the Azadi emissary is worried about rebel attacks on deliveries from the north. They still haven't finished construction on that dreadful tower of theirs. I understand that their empresses, the Six, are arriving for the inauguration. It would probably be a bad blow to the emissary if the tower isn't finished by then.
Good. We'll do our best to ensure that the tower remains unfinished. Any other news I should know about?
Apparently, with so many soldiers tied up in skirmishes in the north and the east, there will be another contingent coming to the city soon. I've heard that it may contain several thousand soldiers. That would obviously make life more difficult for the rebels.
They're not used to the terrain, the woodlands, and the cold. They can send their whole empire for all I care. They will still fail.
I hope you're right, April. Still, it's never a good idea to tempt fate.
Have you heard any other news?
Nothing you do not already know, April.
I hope Bryn hasn't caused any trouble for you. He's a bit hot-headed.
Bryn is a lovely boy. He's been courteous and sweet. He absolutely adores you, April. I hope you realize how much you mean to him.
I saved his life. Or at least I gave him one. He was orphaned and there was no one to look after him.
You did a good thing. But when you save someone's life, especially a child's life, you are also taking responsibility for that life. You may not care much for your own life anymore, April. But for his sake, you need to take care. You need to find something to live for again.
I have something to live for. Revenge.
Revenge is not enough. And it's just another excuse. So the Azadi have murdered friends and loved ones. For that, they must pay. But that is not something to live for, April. Nor is it something to die for. What happens when the enemy is banished? What then?
There's no point thinking that far ahead. Have you spoken to Chuan about the charms?
I did. And they've already been loaded onto the ship. I believe there were 50 of them, enough to get you through the winter. Chuan seems to have changed this past year. There's less anger in him. He seems more concerned with delivering the supplies than murdering Azadi.
I think he's found some peace in the swamplands. And there's a woman. Ayela.
Ah, I see. It is time he left his past behind, to mourn so many for so long.
If anyone has the right to stay angry, it's him. The Azadi took everything from him, killed everyone he loved, enslaved him, and forced him to join their army.
And yet he decides to leave his anger behind and forge a new life for himself. Maybe you have something to learn from him, April.
I'm not him, Benrime. We all find peace in different ways.
And some not at all.
What do you make of Na'ane? She's not been with us long, but she has proven to be an invaluable asset.
An asset? Is this what you call your compatriots? I have not spoken with her much, but she is a skilled artisan. Her magic is strong.
I think she wants to ensure that the Azadi don't proceed any further east. I believe her family holds a high position in the Irhad.
It would make sense for the Sun Empire to rally their armies now, to halt the expansion. But I think the Emperor still hopes for a peaceful solution.
The Six will never accept the hand of a Dolmari ruler. Does the Rose Court think that the Azadi will grant them exemption from their ban on magic? It's naive. And it's dangerous.
So it is. But all we can do is plead with them to see reason. If more Irhadians do what Na'ane has done, we might change the course of this war.
I should be on my way.
Very well. Be careful. And may the balance be with you.
Okay, and after all of that, I still have no idea where I'm supposed to go. I mean, in the short term. In the long term, obviously, I'm going to visit the Dark People. But in the short term, where do I go?
I hope to see you again soon, Ms. Ryan. Best of luck to you.
Alright, time to give trial and error a shot. Go everywhere, click everything. Oh, wait a minute, is this open now? Have I ever been down here? No, this has always been closed. Okay. Isn't that that Nordic-looking guy that was with the training with Kion? Or maybe it's just the same race.
Visit Roper's Spells and Filters for premium quality potions.
Old town's getting too crowded. It just wasn't built to house so many people.
Order potions, herbs, curiously shaped cookies, everything a wizard, witch, or warlock may require, using only the finest organic ingredients. Elguan bladders, rat tails, dung.
Yum.
They've kept the blue flame burning
potions,
here in Old Town for 1,000 years, apparently. It didn't even go out
cookies.
When the tyrant held the city.
What do the Azadi want from us? Why have they stuck us in here? We haven't done anything to them, and we can't help who we are.
Conditions in the ghetto aren't bad, all things considered. We got food and water, and there's medicine and herbs for everyone. What we don't have is freedom.
Old Town's not a bad place to be. If only the Azadi would leave us be, like they promised they would.
Wait, that man. Looks very familiar. Why am I thinking of moving stairways?
Oh, I thought that might be him. It's, was it Roper Klacks?
Good God, Roper Klacks.
Yep.
At your service, m'lady. What may I do for... Wait. I know you. Where do I know you from? April. April Ryan.
Oh, well...
How lovely to see you.
Say what?
It's been too long, my dear. Too long.
Yeah. I guess it's been... long.
What have you been up to?
This and that.
How lovely. Me? I'm rehabilitated.
Sure you are.
rehabilitated. How so?
Being soundly walloped by you was the best thing that ever happened to me.
Really?
Oh, yes. It gave me perspective. Time to think. When I finally escaped that confounding device, I joined WWWA. Wicked Witches and Warlocks Anonymous. It's a marvelous support group for wizarding professionals.
Oh.
Oh, it helped tremendously to find others who shared my affliction.
Affliction?
A desire for evil deeds and world domination, your basic EDWD syndrome.
I see. And now?
Cured! I'm free of my desire to conquer and control, and I'm happy to be a simple merchant and published author.
I guess that's a good thing.
It is. It is indeed. So, April Ryan, is there anything I can do to help repay what you did for me?
Sure. Yeah, how did he get out of the calculator? How did he get into the calculator? I would like to know that, but I guess I'll settle for how he got out.
How did you get out of that calculator I trapped you in?
I had to learn advanced trigonometry. After that, it was as easy as multiplying the root of pi with the volume of my mathematical prison.
Oh, that sounds pretty complicated.
It took me 5 years, but I gained some important personal skills in the process. I even had time to write a book, so it was all for the best.
You said something about being an author?
I published one. I wrote my memoirs a few years ago. Farewell to My Wizarding Days by Roper F. Klacks.
What's the F stand for?
Nothing. It just looked better on the cover. Anyway, as it turned out, the first and only print run had a slight problem. A small charm made its way onto page 108. When readers got to that page, the book, as misfortune would have it, exploded.
You had nothing to do with that.
Me? Absolutely not. I've been acquitted of all charges, and every single lawsuit has been dismissed in the magical court. I'm quite innocent. It does mean, however, that only one copy of Farewell to My Wizarding Days by Roper F. Klacks exists, and that would be mine. I've decharmed it, and page 108 is quite safe to read now, if you're interested.
Not really, no.
Yeah, no thanks.
I actually do need some help.
That's great! Anything to assist the woman who turned my life around.
I'm looking for a way to get to the City of the Dark People.
Visiting old friends, I take it? Your adventures are the stuff of legends, April Ryan. By the way, did you ever read that pamphlet they published? The one with the amusing drawings, April Rye Bread and the Rod of Joy?
What?
Unfortunately, no.
Well, I'll never forget that illustration where the Dolmari lady takes the Rod of Joy and sticks it right...
Anyway, about the Dark People City.
Ah, yes. What do you plan on doing there?
I need to visit their library.
The library? Indeed. They are collectors, these Dark People. They collect all sorts of knowledge, arcane, forbidden knowledge. Anyway, as luck would have it, there's a shadow ship docked down in the harbor right now. I'm sure they'll let the famous April Rybre... April Ryan, I'm sure they will give you passage to their city.
That's perfect, thank you. How do I get to the Dark People's library?
Oh, no, I already know that.
Thanks.
At your service, m'lady. If you ever need a potion or a charm, visit Roper's Spells and Philtres.
Lovely to see you again.
Visit Roper's Spells and Philtres for premium
quality
potions.
See, I see two ways to go.
Ingredients and made to...
Let's see what's down here. It's apparently just a twisty, windy nowhere? Where does this go? Oh, there we go. Ah, here I am. Wait, so I need to get to the dock. How do I get to the dock? Let me see where the other place goes. Okay, where does this go? Is this... Here we go. Oh, he's floating. I didn't know they float. It's a lovely ship you have there. It's a wonderful color of rock. No one walks like that. No one disappears like that.
I'm only in town for a short visit. I will not stay long. I am better off back home.
You look imposing. Oh, nice arm.
The captain. He looks a bit too relaxed, seeing as there are still supplies left to be loaded. How are things going?
Most of the supplies are on board. We're missing a few crates of grains and vegetables, a delivery of potions, and some other bits and pieces.
Good. Don't linger too long.
The paperwork's already being processed by the Azadi. Those fools. If only they knew what...
Shh! Not here. I don't think it's a good idea to tempt fate.
I didn't think you believed in that spiritual claptrap, Raven. Fate? Ha! We make our own destiny.
Still, better to be on the safe side. You don't foresee any problems, then?
Everything's in order. This ship's going to the islands. At least according to all the properly stamped and perfectly forged documents.
I'll rest easy only when you've reached safe harbor.
Don't fret. You'll rest easy soon enough.
What is that thing over there? Huh. Nice legs.
A Samare. I thought they didn't like the ocean. Maybe she's curious. It's one of the dark people. A dark person. He's probably a shadow guide. The captain of that shadow ship.
Hmm. A dark person shadow guide that captains the shadow ship. Seems a bit...
shady.
I seek passage to your city. I wish to visit the library.
We are here to trade and to collect. We do not take on passengers.
That's right, I was called a wave. Everyone wants money. Well, not everyone. I don't think the dark people want money. I don't think they care about that. I don't think he's a man at all. Threaten. Hell no.
A long time ago, I sailed on one of your ships, and I met one of your people. He called me a wave.
Not many of your kind would lay claim to such a title.
I'm not laying claim to anything. I'm just telling you what he told me.
If you were a wave, we would grant you passage. But all I see is a human.
Okay.
I'd like to ask for passage again.
We do not...
Hmm.
I'm sure we can come to some sort of understanding.
We cannot. We do not take on passengers. Ever.
You did once. A long time ago, I was given passage on one of your ships.
Then you were fortunate. It does not happen very often.
Well, damn it.
I'll pay you good money for passage.
We do not crave money, human.
Then what do you want?
We are here to find new additions to our library. Someday it will be complete, and we can sleep. Until then, we travel, and we collect.
Okay, so I'm guessing I need to get them some sort of a rare book.
I'd like to ask...
We do.
I'm desperate. I need to get to your city, to your library. I'm looking for someone.
There are no humans in the city. Rarely is anyone allowed to visit our forest.
Not a human. Someone else. The White of the Drag Kin.
I know of no such creature. You should look elsewhere.
Okay, who might have a rare book?
I'd like to ask...
Oh, I'm not going to threaten him.
How can I...
It is not something you can prove. It is something you are. And you are not a wave.
Then why did one of your people tell me I was?
If you ever were a wave, it is no longer in you. I see only death in your eyes, human.
Well, damn it. Guess I just need to talk to people.
We're on schedule, Raven. We should be out of here soon, bound for the Bay of Fire.
Well, you know what? Maybe, Brian Westhouse. He's a traveler, after all, so he would know and maybe possess some rare books, I would think. Yeah, let's go talk to him. Damn it, I can't see his face. He really likes that machine, doesn't he?
I'll be sure to look you up the next time I'm in Mercuria.
Okay, I guess I don't talk to him.
Perhaps you should begin your search in Old Town.
I need to run.
Very well.
Wonderful.
Benrime's burned all the forbidden books, and she's bought a bunch of Azadi-approved ones. No one reads those.
Hmm. Oh, wait, duh, Jesus Christ. Roper Klacks, he has a book that is extremely rare. There literally exists only one copy. Duh. God, that didn't even come to mind, even though I talked to him about 5 minutes before talking to the Dark People.
April Ryan, what can I do for you?
Would you be interested in parting with that book of yours?
Oh, I don't know. It's the last remaining copy, you know. All the other copies spontaneously combusted.
I'm aware of that, but I need something to get me passage on that shadow ship down in Shady Quay.
You believe my book would help with that?
Maybe. The Dark People collect books, and yours is quite unique. Isn't that so?
It is. It is.
Wouldn't you consider it an honor to have your first published novel become a part of the greatest library in Arcadia?
I would. I would indeed. Wait, I have it right here. I carry it with me always. There you go. Treat it with care. Don't let it get wet. Don't feed it red meat. And for the love of the balance, do not hold it upside down when there's a full moon. Oh, never again shall I glance upon the top 10 reasons why you should not build a flying castle on page 42 and smile knowingly.
But think about it. Thousands of people will get to enjoy your unique outlook on life. Your book will be part of something much, much greater.
You're right. Of course, you're right. Go on, take it away, or I shall become emotional, and when a wizard weeps, the whole world weeps with him. Oh, the humanity, the humanity.
Excellent.
This is the only remaining copy of Klacks' novel, and if I'm lucky, it won't blow up in my hands.
Wait a minute, is this the way to the dock, or was it the other way? I think it was the other way.
Quality potions, magical ingredients, and made to order.
Ah, excuse me. Here you go. Oh. Guess I have to do it through dialogue.
You collect books, isn't that right?
We collect all that is written and recorded. Books, scrolls, stones, crystals, history, poetry, journals, stories. From the first word to someday, the last. Until our collection is complete, we will continue to travel, to trade, and to collect.
I guess the last existing copy of a rare book would be pretty important to you.
It would be. Unless we already possess it.
You don't. Not this one. Farewell to My Wizard in Days by Robert F. Klacks.
I will speak with my brothers at the library. This is a book we do not have. We need it for our library. Will you part with it?
For a price. I need to get to your city.
Show me the book, so that I can see for myself.
Well, I guess he gets cell service out here.
Very well, human. This book is of value to us. We will grant you passage on our shadow ship.
Thank you. When do we leave?
Very soon. We await only the last deliveries from our suppliers. Step aboard.
You sure you don't want anything to eat? I can order in.
I'm not very hungry. Thanks, though.
All right. Some coffee? Tea?
No, thanks.
I have, whiskey.
I'm fine, Damien. Really.
All right.
So, what do you think?
I think you shouldn't believe a word of what that man told you. He was trying to get inside your head. There's no proof that anything's happened to Reza.
I hope you're right. If I've come this far and it turns out Reza's...
Stop it. There's nothing to be gained from imagining the worst. He must be very important to you. Reza, I mean.
He is. Reza was my best friend for so long, and I was totally in love with him. When that feeling went away, I don't love him any less. But it's different now. I don't know what's going on with me. I've lost faith. Not just in him, in everything. School, my friends, my hobbies, my future. Reza. Nothing seems to matter that much anymore. And that's why, when Reza went missing, I knew I had to go after him. Not just because he's my friend, and not just because I love him, but because if I didn't, then who would I be? What would I be? I may not like the Zoë I'm turning into, but I would have hated the Zoë who just abandoned her best friend like that. So, yes, he's very important to me. Of course. And right now, more than anything in the world,
I want him to be okay.
So, that man?
The one in the garden. He acted like he's behind the whole thing. Like he controls Watticorp.
I've heard rumors, but I've never actually believed. I think his name is Alvin Peets.
Peets? The guy who founded Watty?
He'd be several hundred years old, but in a way, it still makes sense. It's a sort of urban water cooler legend. Whatever happened to Alvin Peets? No one knows. But there are lots of theories. Some say they've heard he's been kept alive by machines, and that he still controls Watticorp. It's the kind of thing you have a good laugh at.
He wasn't just hooked up to a machine, Damien. He looked like he was a machine. At least partly so. And he was just... evil. Sad, pathetic and hateful. He claimed that we were stealing his senses. I think he was actually afraid of me.
From what you told me earlier, it sounds like he's completely dependent on the wire. The static must be scaring the hell out of him. If he needs the wire to see and hear, he's completely lost without it.
I just don't feel safe anymore. He knew who I was. He's been inside Reza's dreams. He has spies everywhere. Cameras, bots.
Don't worry, Zoë. He won't find you here, I promise. I'll check around tomorrow. See if I can dig up any information on Peets. You must be tired. I'm keeping you up.
I'm sorry. I'm just... Yeah, I am quite tired. I guess I should find a hotel and figure out what to do next. Thanks for the clothes, Damien. I'll...
Hey, no, there's no need to find a hotel. You can stay here. I mean, if you're comfortable with that. I can sleep on the floor.
Oh, you really don't have to.
I know, but you've been through a lot, and you're helping me out, so the least I can do is let you sleep in my bed. That didn't come out right. You know what I mean.
Thanks, Damien. If you're okay with me staying here, I will.
Okay, so, let me get the bed ready for you.
That's okay, I can...
I guess you can give me a hand.
Okay. Yes. Great.
By the way, if I'm gone when you wake up tomorrow, don't be alarmed. I have to be at the office quite early.
Oh, that's okay. I'll be fine. I'll just stay here.
Good. Let me find you a sheet and a cover.
This is it, Apostle. The Empire's greatest achievement east of Sadir. A monument to our might and to our faith.
Even in Sadir, there is nothing that can compare to this. Why was it built so tall?
You're asking the wrong man. I don't question the infinite wisdom of the Six. I have absolute faith in their decisions.
Of course, as do we all.
Go right inside, Apostle. The Emissary is expecting you.
God, these people are just creepy drones. Alright, well, this is a good spot to end this here, so I'm gonna end the episode, get a stretch in. Okay. I hope you have enjoyed so far, and I will be back soon.